You've all heard of scores of people converting to Islam in recent times, especially Christians, right? However, we hardly come across instances when a Christian missionary discovers the truth about Islam and accepts it. Well, in this video, we will be going over one such instance, an American woman based in California named Mary Sue Malvar, or more commonly known as Khadija Watson. So it began with having a BA and an MA in theology. Khadija Watson was a licensed Christian missionary who spent 7 years preaching Christianity in the Philippines. Never in her wildest dreams could she think that one day she would end up becoming a Muslim, as she was taught that Islam was satanic and demonic. So what happened that made her question her deep-rooted beliefs? While she was studying church history, she came to know that the concept of Trinity was introduced 325 years after the passing of Jesus Christ. Regarding this, she went to her professors bearing questions. Unfortunately, their explanations didn't satisfy her. Khadija also wondered that if the teachings of Christianity were true, why weren't they making any difference to society, which was only getting worse day by day? Anyhow, moving on. During her time as a missionary in the Philippines, where she worked as a professor in two colleges, she also enrolled in a German language class. There, she made acquaintance with a Filipino, whose kindness and gentleness really impressed her. He always carried a plastic bag along that contained coins. He used to distribute these coins to the beggars in the street. Khadija later found out that this Filipino guy was a Muslim convert from Christianity. In the same classroom, there was a Filipina Muslim convert as well, who had also given up Christianity for Islam. Sister Khadija says, "I could not believe I had met two Christians in 1 week who had become Muslims, especially a woman. I was under the impression, like so many Westerners, that Islam considered women second-class citizens, and that their husbands locked them up and beat them." The Filipina introduced Khadija to the beauty of Islam and how, in reality, it is a liberator of women and provides protection to their rights. Khadija soon realized that it is actually the Western society that mistreats women. In the United States, every 4 minutes, a woman is beaten by her spouse or partner so badly that she needs to go to the emergency room. In the UK, the same thing happens every 2 minutes. These statistics are based on reported cases only. So as soon as Khadija opened up her eyes to facts, she felt a sudden stirring in her heart. She wondered if she had been wrong about Islam all along. Khadija began to pray, asking the Lord to show her signs if Islam is wrong. The Filipina that Khadija had met in the German language class suggested her visit the Islamic Center. Accordingly, she went there and was shocked by the approach of the Muslims. Khadija says, "As a missionary, I was familiar with many evangelical strategies and methods. These Muslims used nothing. There was no harassment, no psychological manipulation, and no subliminal suggestion. They simply gave me some books and told me they would answer any questions I had." Following their instructions, Khadija went home and read those books. It was the first time she had read books about Islam written by Muslims. Earlier, all the books that she had read were authored by Christians. She was astonished to find out that Allah is one, the omnipotent, and the omnipresent. Khadija says, "There was no go-between, no priest. I went back to the Islamic Center the very next day, and guess what? They gave me more books." So after spending hours in reading and having more than 15 discussions, Khadija came to the conclusion that the Holy Quran is indeed authentic. Khadija says that the Bible has more than 66 books, 40 authors, and was written in various languages, whereas the Holy Quran is one and only, and has not changed unlike the Bible. Fully convinced of the truth of Islam, she uttered her Shahada and became a Muslim. Regarding the name Khadija, she says that she chose this name because, like Khadija, I was a widow. I embraced Islam at about the same age as she was when she converted. I also have 9 children as she had. Moving on, Khadija's conversion to Islam evoked disappointing reactions from her family and friends and colleagues. She was fired from her teaching job, rejected by her former classmates, professors, and co-pastors, and suspected by her own country's government. Her in-laws, who were based in the Philippines and had a very cordial relationship with her even after the death of her husband, completely abandoned her. Her children, on the other hand, had an emergency meeting, devising a plan on how to bring their mother back to her senses. When they first saw Khadija in an abaya and a hijab, they were shocked and told her that she resembled an extremist. Khadija's 18-year-old son, however, became a Muslim later on, something which Khadija couldn't believe. She says, "He was so into music and dating and was not ready for any kind of religion. I used to leave books for him to read, but I found them untouched. But I prayed a lot for him and all my children to become Muslim. Later, when he converted to Islam, he confessed that he had read all the books and kept me from knowing. He was the one who went to Mecca first. When he came back, he told me excitedly, 'Mom, you will love Saudi Arabia. All the women dress like you.'" Anyway, Sister Khadija later enrolled as a teacher at Al Hamra Islamic Education Foundation in Jeddah, where she began preaching Islam. She says that she is so grateful to Allah for being a Muslim and prays that she may live and die a Muslim. Khadija Watson passed away at the age of 75 in Saudi Arabia on July 16, 2018. She leaves behind a lasting legacy through her dawah, charity work, and compassion. She continues to be an inspiration for every Muslim to this day. May Allah accept her and forgive all her mistakes. Ameen.